I retrieved the bobbing ball from the swirling whirlpool, wetting my sleeve in the process, and tossed it back to him after drying it off. He caught it and served immediately before I even got to my side of the table. The ball bounced away toward the door. I paused, not wanting to chase it, and hoping he would just continue with his exposition. Tiny looked at me with incredulous hostility.
Get the goddamn ball already! The score is 3-0, play to 5.
I retrieved the ball once again, feeling more like a dog playing fetch than an opponent. This time it lay nestled on a velvet cushion on his antique sofa as if it were a Fabergé egg. Tiny continued with his explanation of my assignment, which, in spite of everything, was beginning to intrigue me.
Our client has been attempting to create viruses that elicit predictable psychological effects.
Who's the client? And what are the effects of this virus? I waited until I reached my side of the table to toss the ball to him this time. He caught the ball and paused, frowning.
Everything you need to know is contained in the memo you will receive. Rest assured that this research is proceeding according to established protocols. As a matter of fact, one of your colleagues in the former philosophy department is currently developing a paper exploring the ethics involved in such research. Feel free to contact her. I can't recall her name. But she's the philosopher we retained for the new humanities department.
Dr. Carthorse? He was talking about Blip's wife, Sophia.
That's the one. I always get her and the historian confused. She's a woman, too.
Without warning, he served the ball, this time giving it a backspin. It curved crazily after it bounced, and I managed to catch it to avoid having to give chase once again.
What the hell was that, Fountain?
He barked at me like a high school gym teacher. Sorry. I tossed it back to him and ignored his abrasive manners.